Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social This Side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about event handlers. So before going forward, if you haven't watched part 54 of this video series, so I would strongly recommend to watch that video. So let's start with event handler. So in our last video we have discussed about error handling and how we can handle the errors if error will be occurred in our package. So first we can configure at the source, transformation and destination level, and then by event handler. So in event handler, let's create a scenario and then we will discuss how we can handle the error. So go to on SSDT, and here I would like to add one more package. Then I wish to rename this package event handler. Then I wish to use execute SQL task, then double click on this execute SQL task. Here I need to make a connection. So here I would like to create new connection. As I have already created the connection, so I am going to use that one. Click on OK. Here in SQL statement, I would like to use select 1 divided by 0. So it will reflect an error once our package will be executed. Now click on OK. So on every execution this package will be failed. So how we can handle the error? So go to on event handler. We can click on error event handler. So here as we can see in event handler we have many more options. First is on error, on information, on post execute, on post execute validate, and many more options. So I am very interested to use on error. If error will be occurred in our package, then this will be executed, and inside this executable, as we can see, we can set at the package level and also we can set as the task level. So this is our task. As we have only one execute SQL task, that's why we are getting only one. So I wish to use in package level. Now click on OK. I have created a table with the name of errors, and it has only one column with the error description. So once our package will be failed, then I just want to capture the error description, why our package will be failed. So here I need to use execute SQL task, double click on this, then on the connection I gonna use existing connection. In SQL statement here we need to use insert into errors and error description, and here we need to specify values and question mark. So we will get the value from the variable. Now click on OK. Now go to on parameter mapping. So here I need to add a new parameter, then in the variable name I want to use error description. So this is our system variable, and we can also use user defined variables. So data type would be varchar. So we can select varchar. Then parameter name. In parameter name we need to specify index, so it would start from 0. Then parameter size, so parameter size would be anything, so I want to use as 500. Now click on OK. Now we can save this package. So our package will be executed. Then if error will be occurred, then our event handler where we have specified one more execute SQL task, so this execute SQL task will be executed. Now click on start. So as you can see package failed. We can check in event handler. So this execute SQL task executed successfully. Now we can stop this package. Go to on SSMS. Now we can refresh this table. One record has been inserted. So we can find select 1 divided by 0 failed with the following error, and error is divided by 0 error encountered. So this is our error, that's why our package failed. So here after capturing the information, if I wish to send an email, so we can use send mail task inside this event handler, and we can connect with execute SQL task, and we can configure send mail task as I haven't discussed about the send mail task. So I would discuss this in our upcoming videos, so we can use according to our requirement. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.